Welcome to the course on understanding bacteria in the kitchen. Before we can understand how bacteria affects your food, we need to define what bacteria is. So what is bacteria? Bacteria is a single-celled microorganism which can exist either as an independent, in other words, free-living organism, or as a parasite, meaning it's dependent upon another organism for life. They are about 0.5 to 2 micrometers in size. To give this some perspective, a single grain of sand is 2 millimeters in size. This means that you could fit 1,000 bacterial cells into a single grain of sand. So how do we see bacteria? Well, bacteria form what we call colonies, which have millions of cells which allow us to easily see bacteria in a medium that is grown in the lab, known as agar plates. This is the easiest method in order to identify and see bacteria. Bacteria were one of the very first organisms to exist on our planet and have coexisted with us since the beginning of time. There are millions of different types of bacteria, some good for you and some very dangerous to your health. So where do we find bacteria? Well, the simple answer is everywhere. As an example, bacteria on a human-associated level grows in your gut, on your skin and in your hair, including eyelashes. So much so that recent research has shown that the makeup of different bacteria in your gut and on your skin is more unique than an actual fingerprint. Bacteria also grow and survive in the food that we eat. Raw meat and vegetables by design need to be cooked so that we as humans can consume these foods without getting sick from bacteria that thrive in these environments. There are two main types of bacteria, which we define as gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria. All commonly occurring bacteria fall under these two categories. Suffice to say, we identify bacteria in the lab with a simple test that we use as a broad category to determine which bacteria we are looking at. This is known as a gram stain. So without getting too complicated, this means that there are two main types of bacteria that look and behave differently from each other. There are, of course, good and bacteria all around us, and not to be an alarmist, most bacteria are good for us and help us improve our environment.